Standard 10. Math. Exercise 2.3 of polynomial. Chapter 2. Now sum number 1. Divide the polynomial p of x by the polynomial g of x and find the quotient and remainder in each of the following. Now first question. P of x is given x cube minus 3x squared plus 5x minus 3, and g of x is equals to x square minus 2. X cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. Now, when we divide this polynomial by x square minus 2, now understand the important method. Divide always first to first term. What I will do? X cube divided by x square, first to first term. So answer will be x, right? X cube divided by x square, answer will be x. So I will put x as a quotient. Now x into x square, that is x cube, x into 2x, that is minus 2x. Clear? Now if you wish to do it properly, you should write 0x in between. What you should do? 0x in between. Let me do it again. Do not consider this one. X cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. I do not have the midterm, that is x. So I will put 0x minus 2. I have added the midterm. Now, divide first term by first term. X cube divided by x square, that will be x. Now I will multiply this x with x square, that is x cube. X into x, 0x, that is 0x square. And x into 2, that is minus 2x. Now change the sign, minus, minus, and plus. This is nothing new. You have already done it in standard 9, right? Now x cube minus x cube, 0. Minus 3x square and minus 0x square. So I will write as it is minus 3x square. Then plus 5x plus 2x. Now you should forget this sign. Do not consider minus sign. It is now plus. So 5 plus 2, that is 7x. And carry minus 3. Carry minus 3. Now again, first to first term, I will divide minus 3x square divided by x square. X square, x square cut, that is minus 3. X square cut, that is minus 3. So, minus 3 into x square, minus 3x square, minus 3 into 0x, that is 0x. And minus 3 into minus 2, that is plus 6. Minus, minus, plus. Now again change the sign. Plus, minus, minus. Now minus 3x squared plus 3x squared. 0. 7x, here 0x, so we'll write plus 7x. And minus 6 minus 3, that is minus 9. Minus, minus, plus. Now we cannot divide further because your denomination is greater than numerator, right? Here 7x and here x squared. So we are not able to further divide the polynomial. So what we will write the final answer is quotient is x minus 3, remainder is 7x minus 9. Quotient is x minus 3, remainder is 7x minus 9. Now, second. P of x is given x4 minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5. And g of x is equals to x square plus 1 minus x. Can I write x square minus x plus 1 in order?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's divide it. X raised to 4 minus 3x square is only. So also one term missing here. So can I write x4 plus 0x cube minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5? Right? I have added 0x square. X cube, sorry. So x4 minus 0x cube minus 3x square or plus 0x cube minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5. Now let's divide it by x square minus x plus 1. Now let's write first term. Here it is x4, here it is x square. So x4 divided by x square, that is x square, right? Four terms divided by two terms, right? Raised to 4, 4 degree divided by 2 degree is 2 degree. So here it will be x square into x square, that is x raised to 4. X square into x, that is minus x cube. X square into 1, that is plus x square. Now change the sign, minus plus minus. X4 minus x4, 0. Here, plus will now become plus x cube. 0 is not considered. It will be plus x cube. And minus 3 minus 1, that is minus 4x square. 3 and 1, 4. Now I will drop down one polynomial. One term, that is 4x plus. Now once again, first term. X cube divided by x square, that is x. So x plus, so x into x cube, x square x cube, x into x, that is x square, x into 1, that is x. Now change the sign. It is plus, then minus, minus, then plus, then minus. Now let's do x cube minus x cube, 0. Minus 4 plus 1, that is minus 3x square. 4 minus 1, sign of greater number. Then 4 minus 1, that is plus 3x plus 5. 5 is carried down, right? Drop down. Now, first term, that is minus 3x square. Minus 3x square divided by x square, answer will be minus 3. So let's write minus 3 into 1, 3x square minus. Minus minus plus 3x and 3 ones are minus 3. Now change the sign, plus minus plus. So here 0. Here also 0, but 5 plus 3 is 8. 5 plus 3 is 8. So what will be my answer? My answer quotient is x square plus x minus 3. And remainder is 8. Remainder is 8. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now question number 3 of first sum. P of x, x4 minus 5x plus 6. Now see, two terms, cube and square, both are missing. So I will write x4 plus 0x square, x cube plus 0x square minus 5x plus 6. And g of x, that is 2 minus x square. So can I write minus x square plus 0x plus 2 minus x square plus, midterm is missing, x, coefficient with x, and last term is 2 minus x square plus 0x plus 2. Now let's divide. X4 plus 0x cube plus 0x square minus 5x plus 6. Minus x square plus 0x plus 2. Now let's do write down first term. So x4 divided by minus x square. If I divide it, answer will be minus x square. Right? x4 divided by x square, I will give minus sign to it. So now my quotient will be minus x square. Now minus x square into minus x square, that is x raised to 4 plus minus minus. Minus x square into 0x, that is 0x cube. And minus x square into 2, minus 2x square. Minus minus plus, now plus minus 0, here it is 0x cube plus 2x square minus 5x, right? Now can I directly write all these three, because first term is already 0. We need not have to multiply. So we are not considering this term 0. So we'll write 0 here. Now, again, first term plus 2x square divided by minus x square. So answer will be minus 2. Let's multiply it. Minus 2 into minus x square, that is 2x square. Minus 2 into 0x, that is 0x. And minus 2 into 2, minus 4. Minus, minus, plus. 2 minus 2, 0. This is minus 5x. And 6 plus 4, 10. 6 plus 4, 10. So, what my answer should be? The remainder minus 5x plus 10 and quotient minus x square minus 2. Minus x square minus 2. Clear to some? Sum number 2. First, check whether the first polynomial is factor of second polynomial by dividing the second polynomial by the first polynomial. Let's see. P of x, we are taking 2 t raised to 4, 3 t cube minus 2 t square minus 9 t minus 12, and we divide it by g of x, that is t square minus 3. So we can write t square minus plus 0 t minus 3. We have added a t in between, 0 t, right? Now let's divide. If answer remainder is coming 0, then it is a factor. We can say second polynomial is a factor of first polynomial is a factor of second polynomial. 2 t raised to 4, 3 t cube, 2 t square, 9 t minus 12. T square plus 0 t minus 3. Two t raised to 4 divided by t square, first term. So it will be 2 t square. Write down 2t square into t square, 2t raised to 4. 2t square into 0t, that is 0t raised to q. 3 into 6, that is minus 6t square. Now, minus, minus, and plus, changing the sign. So here it is 0, here 3t cube, and plus 6 minus 2, that is plus 4t square. Now, we will carry one term minus 90. Now plus 3t cube divided by t square, so it will be 3t. When we divide this term by this term, answer will be 3t. So let's add 3t. 3t into t square, 3t cube. 3t into 0t, that is 0t square. And 3t into 3, that is 9t minus. So, minus, minus, and plus. 0, 4t square, minus 0t, plus 9, minus 9, 0t, minus 12. Now again, we have to divide 4t square. 4t square divided by t square, it will be 4. So, 4 ones are 4t square. 4 into 0, that is 0t. And 4 3 is a minus 12. Minus, minus, plus 0, 0, and 0. So what we can say here, quotient is 2t square plus 3t plus 4, and remainder is 0. Therefore, t square minus 3 is a factor of 2t4 plus 3t3 minus 2t square minus 9t minus 12. the final answer. Clear? Everyone?
Yes.
Okay, second question. Sum number two, second. Now here we have P of x 3x 4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2 and g of x is equal to x square plus 3x plus 1. Now let's check by dividing 3x 4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2 divided by x square plus 3x plus 1. Now these are first terms of both polynomial, right? We'll divide 3x4 divided by x square, it is 3x square. Now 3x square into x square, 3x4. 3x square into 3x, that is 9x cube. 3x square into 1, that is 3x square. Now changing sign, minus, minus, minus. 0, minus 9 plus 5, that is minus 4x cube. Then minus 7 minus 3, that is minus 10x square. Plus 2x, we are carrying, right? Now, again first term, 4x cube divided by x square, that is minus 4x. We have to write minus 4x here. First term. Now minus 4x into x square minus 4x cube. Minus 4x into 3, that is minus 12x square. 4 3s are 12. And minus 4 into 1, that is minus 4x. Now plus, plus, plus. Here it is 0. 12 minus 2, 10, that is 2x square. Plus 4 plus 2, that is 3x, and plus 2, we are carrying down this 2. We are carrying down this 2. Now 2x square divided by x square, first term. So what I have to multiply with? 2. Now 2 into x square, 2x square. 2 into 3, that is 6x, 3 threes are 6x, and 2 ones are 2. Sign change. So all will become 0. So your quotient will be 3x square minus 4x plus 2. Remainder will be 0. Therefore, it is a factor. In short, you can read. Right? X cube. X square plus 3x plus 1 is factor of 3x4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2. Next, number 3. Third one. P of x is x raised to 5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1. And g of x, with which we have to divide, x cube minus 3x plus 1. What we will do? We'll add 0x square. Right? Now it is quite easy for dividing. So x5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1. 5. Oh, we do not have also 4. We are adding x5 plus 0x4 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1. 6 terms are there. And divide it by x cube plus 0x square minus 3x plus 1. Now let's divide. X5 divided by x raised to 3, that is x squared. So x square into x cube, that is x raised to 5. X square plus 0x square, that is 0x raised to 4. Then x square into 3x minus 3x cube, and x square into 1, that is x square. Now minus, minus, plus, minus. 0, 0, here. Minus 4 plus 3 minus x cube only. Here, x square minus x square, that is 0x square plus 3x. Plus 1. Just a minute. Now see, minus x cube divided by x cube, first term. So it is minus 1. We multiply with minus 1, it is minus x cube minus plus 0x square. Either you write 0x square plus or minus, it doesn't make any difference because we have a 0. Either it can be plus or minus. It doesn't have any effect. Minus 1 into 3, that is plus 3x. Minus 1 into 1, that is minus 1. Plus, plus, minus, and plus. 0, 0, 0, 1 plus 1, 2. So here, quotient is x square minus 1, remainder is 2, right? Therefore, remainder should be 0 for factor. Here not coming 0, right? 0 is not coming. Therefore, it is not a factor. It is not a factor. Now, sum number 3. Sum number 3 is very important. Operate all other zeros of P of X. 3x4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. If 2 of its 0, now understand, we have 4 exponents. So we must have 4 zeros, right? We must have 4 zeros. Out of that, 2 zeros are already given. Now let's check. X is equals to root 5 by 3, x is equals to minus root 5 by 3. Now let's, first of all, let's do square. So x square is equals to we are multiplying these two terms. So x square is equals to, if you remove them, answer will be 5/3. X square is equals to 5/3. Getting x is equals to -√3. X is equals to plus root by 3. √5/3. Right? When we multiply x like this, x into x is equals to √5/3 into -√5/3. Or we can write in a different way. For example, if we want to do it in this way, we take this on this side, x minus √5/3 is equals to 0, and x plus √5/3 is equals to 0. Now, when we take this 2, x whole square minus √5/3 whole square is equals to 0, a minus b, a plus b, that is a square minus b square factorization. X square minus √5/5, √3/3. Now, if we take LCM, it will be 3x² - 5. And when we multiply 3 with 0, it will be 0. So, what we can write here, this is your g of x, with which you have to divide the polynomial. 3x² - 5. So, we can write, therefore, g of x is equals to 3x² + 0x - 5. Now let's divide this polynomial with 3x^4 + 6x³ - 2x² - 10x - 5 divided by 3x² + 0x - 5. X4 divided by x square. There is x square. First term division. So now, x² into 3x² = 3x^4, x² into 0x, that is 0x³, and x² into 5 - 5x² - + 0, 6x³, 5 - 2, that is 3x² - 10x. Now further, (6x³/3x²), 3 2s are, and (x³/x²), that is 2. So let's multiply with 2x into 3, that is 6x³. Now 2x into 0, that is 0x², and 2x into 2, that is 5 2s are 10, minus plus 0, 3x² + 0x - 5. Now, 3x² / 3x², that is 1. So what we multiply with? 1. 3x² + 0x - 5. 1 into 3x², 1 into 0x, 1 into -5. Minus plus 0 0 0. So what is your quotient? x² + 2x + 1. Now can we factorize this and remainder is 0? Can we factorize 2x² It is x whole square, 2 into first term into last term whole square, right? So it is x + 1 whole square. Now we are getting two other zeros. If we factorize x plus 1 whole square is equals to 0, we'll get x is equals to minus 1, x is equals to minus 1, two times. X plus 1 whole square is equals to 0, so it will be like this, understand? X plus 1 is equals to 0, x plus 1 is equals to 0. Therefore, x is equals to minus 1. So what they want to find, all other zeros. So total zeros, x is equals to root 5 by 3 minus root 5 by 3 minus 1 and minus 1. Total 4 zeros are there. Total 4 zeros are there. Now, sum number 4. I will not do fifth one, but I will explain in the next lecture. Let's do sum number 4. On dividing x cubed minus 3x squared plus x plus 2 by polynomial g of x, the quotient and remainder were, see here different thing is given. Now before doing this sum, understand any polynomial, for any polynomial, it can be dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Means P of x is equals to divisor, that is g of x, quotient, that is s of x, and or q of x, and last remainder is r of x. It is framed by this formula. Now I am putting all the values. P of x is given x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2. The divisor g of x is missing in this sum. But quotient is given. What is your quotient? Is x minus 2. And what is the remainder? It is minus 2x plus 4. Is it fine? This is p of x dividend. This is g of x, not given divisor. What is quotient? X minus 2. And what is the remainder? Minus 2x plus 4. Now, first of all, what we do, we take this on this side. So, x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 minus into bracket minus 2x plus 4 is equals to g of x into x minus 2. X cube minus 3x square plus x minus 2 minus minus plus 2x minus plus minus 4 is equals to g of x into x minus 2. Now x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2, that is 3x, and 2 minus 4, that is minus 2, is equals to g of x into x minus 2. Now what we will do, we'll take this x minus 2 in division. We'll take this x minus 2 in division. So x cubed minus 3x squared plus 3x minus 2 upon x upon 2, x minus 2, that is equals to 0. So what we have to ultimately do, we have to divide this polynomial by x minus 2. Then we will get g of x. So x cubed minus 3x squared plus 3x minus 2 divided by x minus 2. Now x cubed divided by x, that is x squared. Let's multiply x squared into x, x cubed, x squared into 2 minus 2x squared. Minus plus 0. minus 3 plus 2, that is minus x squared plus 3x. Now minus x square divided by x, that is minus x into x, minus x square and minus minus plus 2x. Now 3 minus 2, that is x and minus 2. So x by x answer will be 1. I have multiplied with 1. 1 into x, x, 1 into 2. Minus 2, 0, 0. First term, first term, first term, first term. So finally, what is your g of x? Is your quotient? G of x is equals to x squared minus x plus 1. G of x is equals to x squared minus x plus 1. Getting? Everyone?
Yes.
I'm sharing all the sums. First of all, just view all of them. Wow.